Welcome everybody to the start of the finals of Census 2017. Census is the international student competition on molecular biosensors for healthcare applications. And what you're going to see now is the heart of it. It's the testing of the biosensors that the teams have developed over the past 9 months. This is really the moment of truth, because a biosensor is meant to measure something, and that's what the teams are going to do now with real biological samples. So my name is Menno Prins. I'm a professor here at Eindhoven University of Technology, and I'm here together with Danny van der Haven, and he's the vice chair of the Census organization. Because Census is being organized by students, and you can recognize them by their white shirts, and I also have the white shirt. The aim of Census is to stimulate education and innovation in the field of biosensing with a worldwide ambition. And that's why I'm very happy to introduce to you the teams that come from many countries. We have 10 teams today. We have a team from Sweden, we have one from Denmark, one from Scotland, England, one from Belgium, one from the Netherlands, one from Germany, one from Switzerland, one from Egypt, but they have a problem with their flight, but they can come in anytime, the team from Egypt. And we have one team from the United States, from North Carolina. They have traveled the longest distance, they suffer the most from a jet lag, and I hope that they'll be doing very fine today. I would like to welcome the jury. The jury consists of university professors, of healthcare professionals, patient organization, and also industrial companies. And we will call their names individually. Actually, Danny will do that in a moment. I also welcome the sponsors of Census, the sponsors that support the Census competition. I welcome invitees and all other guests here today. This year is the second edition of Census. Last year, we had the first edition. There, the theme was kidney failure, and the biomarker to detect was creatinine. Creatinine is present when the kidney starts to fail, and creatinine was measured in blood plasma. This year, the theme is heart failure. It's an important problem. There are tens of million people in the world, everywhere in the world, suffering from this disease. And it's very difficult to diagnose and monitor the disease. So for doctors, for nurses and patients, there's a need to have tools to better diagnose and monitor the disease. And the biomarker that goes with heart failure and that will be measured today is NT-proBNP. It's a difficult name, but it's a protein. It's a protein that is present in blood when the heart fails. It's important to know that it's a very, very difficult biomarker. Not only it's difficult to measure something directly in blood, but this biomarker, NT-proBNP, has a very low concentration. It's 1 million times lower in concentration than creatinine, the biomarker of last year. So it's really a tough challenge that the teams have taken up this year. So I think we should very respectfully look at what they have built. These are complicated instruments, and the test is very difficult to do. But I hope, of course, very much that there will be several sensors that give good data, and the teams that biosensors will work well. Because as you may know, if you travel from a long distance, then Murphy is around the corner. Murphy is this phenomenon that anything that can go wrong will one moment go wrong. So it's really a tough challenge to have a biosensor now here working, but it has to work because the teams will get real biological samples from the here at this competition. Okay, so how have these teams worked? Well, they have been very courageous because, as I said already, it's very difficult to develop a biosensor. And they've all worked with multiple disciplines on board. For example, a physicist, a chemist, a biochemist, a mechanical engineer, an electrical engineer, a computer scientist, and maybe even somebody from innovation sciences. And this multidisciplinarity and the multidisciplinary way of working is really, really difficult. And that's one of the main learning points within Census. So I wish the teams a lot of success when they do their measurements, when they present their posters, when they present their pitches, and when they answer your questions. Because They have been in census to learn, but they are here to share their learning, and also you should learn while you are here at the competition. Census is for students by students. So it's organized by students from Eindhoven University. As I said already, it's the students with the white shirts. And it's really a big effort over a whole year to organize such a competition. So I advise you to admire their talents today and to, of course, enjoy the event that they have organized.